Hello, welcome to Epilepsy Insight number 11. My name is Katie. So recently, over the past few months, I have been in contact with a few different women who are recently diagnosed with catamenial epilepsy. And it just brought back all of the memories of my diagnosis back in 2009 and all of the confusion and the whirlwind that comes with a diagnosis with a disease like epilepsy and just how confusing and scary it is. It's really, my neurologist did not tell me a lot of things that I wish he would have. It would have possibly helped me to prevent some seizure activity as well. So here is, from a personal perspective, from an epileptic, for you ladies who may have just been diagnosed, a few pieces of advice that I wish I had been given when I was first diagnosed. So number one is to focus on your diet. Believe it or not, your diet has a lot to do with your seizures, and it can have a lot to do with preventing seizure activity as well, because a lot of processed food products contain excitotoxins. And so when it comes to processed foods, like just snack foods you can get from the grocery store, and a lot of, let's see, like oven lasagna, oven pizzas, all these foods that are super easy to make and very convenient, they are actually really, really bad for you. And they can cause some seizures. They contain a lot of hormones. They contain a lot of chemical ingredients, just a lot of things that your body really does not need at this time, especially when it's trying to adjust to the craziness of epilepsy. I mean, you want to try and take some of the pressure off, and changing your diet is a really, really great way to do that. So clean eating, organic, is super important. You want to do everything organic because pesticides are so bad for you and they can cause more seizures. Another thing too is the hormones that are usually present in a lot of processed food products. Like I mentioned before, catamenial epilepsy specifically is caused by a hormone imbalance. So you want to avoid synthetic hormones like the plague. You just don't want to have anything to do with them, and you want to really take a look at the ingredient label on the back of the box of a product that you're looking at to buy. And if it has some ingredients that you don't recognize, you probably don't want to eat it. So this does mean a lot more time spent in the kitchen. And I understand that it's time consuming and we don't always have the time to do it, but it's worth it. It's worth it to prevent your seizure activity. It's worth it to keep you stable. And it's just worth it to be healthy. So your diet, really focus on that and try to, if you can, eliminate a lot of ingredients, a lot of foods, processed foods from your diet. Try and focus on clean eating, making things from scratch and making it with ingredients that you know are organic and you know exactly where they've come from. You don't have to worry if they're from a lab or if they're going to cause an issue for you. You know, right? From the very beginning, you know exactly what's in this food, and that is the best thing you can do for yourself. And I wish that I had known that, because I had been eating a diet filled with processed foods and I had no idea how important it was to eliminate them and how much it could do for my condition and how much it could actually maybe prevent some activity. So I have that sort of, like, you look back and you can see things so clearly and you think, oh, if I had known something that I know now, maybe I could have prevented something. But I'm exactly where I'm supposed to be, so everything is okay. But right after my diagnosis, I really wish I had known to change my diet, because I would have. I would have cleaned it up and I would have started learning how to cook, become a little baker. And actually, I enjoy baking. It's so much fun. So, and it's so good to know that my food is healthy. So that's awesome too. Another thing to do is to get a blood work panel done to check your deficiencies, because to really understand what's going on outside your body when you have a seizure, to understand what's causing it, you need to know what's going on inside first. Your vitamin and mineral deficiencies, they have a big story to tell and they have a lot to do with your seizure activity. So every body is different and every person is going to have different deficiencies. So it's really important to understand your own. So you can get a blood work panel, a lot of different type of blood work panels from Great Plains Laboratory. They have a website. It's just greatplains.com. And you can go on and order a kit and take it to, they'll deliver it to your house. And then you can take it to a lab such as LabCorp or something like that locally where they can actually draw the blood for you. And it's, they make it so simple and it just, it gives you a lot of insight. And I wish that I had known this in the beginning, because then I could have started fixing and correcting those deficiencies a lot sooner than I have now. But I'm aware of a lot of my deficiencies now, and it's good to know. And it's good to work on fixing the source of the problem, because that is the most important thing you can do if you're going to stop your seizures. So lastly, I want to tell you how important it is to avoid hormones in your life, in your lifestyle. You can get, hormones are in dairy, they are in makeup, they are in fragrances. It's so, when you're going and purchasing products, you want to get a fragrance-free product, whether it's like feminine products, for example. They often have a lot of scents added, and you want to get unscented every single time, because those scents, I guarantee you, they have hormones in them. And when you put it near your body or on your body, it's going to transfer those hormones into your body, and then your body's struggling even more so. I've actually, I think it was about 5 years into my diagnosis with epilepsy, I completely eliminated perfume from my lifestyle. So I had quite the little collection going too. So we love perfume. Perfume is so fun. It makes us smell nice, and that is always nice. But it is so bad for you. Putting perfume on your skin, it's absorbed really quickly through the skin on your neck and on your wrists. And so eliminating perfume is a really wonderful thing to do for your body. And replacing it, if you still want to use some kind of scent, with essential oils instead. Vanilla essential oil smells so good. I love it. So I've been able to replace my perfumes with that. But doing that and getting ahead of the game is so important. It's also super important whenever you're going out for any type of product. Like if it's makeup, foundation often has fragrance added to it as well, and you want to avoid that. It's so bad. So fragrance in general, just stay away from. I wish I knew that. I wish I knew to avoid it at the very beginning, because I could have avoided exposing my body to so many other synthetic hormones. And instead of creating more of a problem with my hormone imbalance, maybe I could have fixed it. So for those of you ladies who have just been diagnosed and who are dealing with a hormone imbalance, just stay away from it. Eliminate those products from your lifestyle. And I know it can be kind of a challenge, and I know it's not always something you want to do, but it's something you need to do if your body is going to be able to heal. Because constant exposure to synthetic hormones, you're never going to heal if you keep exposing your body to that. So some sacrifices have to be made, and I'm sorry to be the bearer of bad news, but it's so worth it, and I wish someone told me. I wish I knew. I wish my neurologist had said, you know what, do this and avoid this, and you know, this could be a cause for seizures, so avoid that as well. And when I first met with my neurologist after my diagnosis, I felt like I was being herded in like cattle. It was, first of all, we waited for 2 hours in the waiting room, and then he told me whenever I asked him a very in-depth question, he would say, just go live your life. Just go live your life. It's fine. And it's like, well, I'm trying to go live my life. I would like to know how to live my life, but I'm now having seizures. So excuse me, sir, but I need some help here. So hopefully this is helpful to you, and hopefully it gives you some insight into a few of the things that you can do for yourself and just kind of clean up your lifestyle and hopefully in the end avoid more seizure activity. So as always, ladies, good luck with your life. And if you have any questions, please feel free to email me. And my email is below in the description. So best of luck, and I hope you're all doing well.